a second time. If a tail occurs on the first flip, then six face die is tossed. Assuming that the outcomes are equally likely, what is the probability of getting one head and one tail? Okay, so that is our question. Okay, what they are saying, we are tossing a coin or flipping a coin, and if head occurs, that means if I am flipping a coin, if head occurs, what I'll again toss this coin. I'll again toss the coin. Then I can get a head or tail there. If I'm getting a tail, means I'll toss a die. So I can get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And what is the probability that I need to find? Probability is getting one head and one tail. Very simple. It's going to be very simple. That is, what are the samples? What is the sample space? HH, HT, T1, T2, T3, T4, T5, T6, right? These are the sample space. These are the elements of sample space. So I need to get one head and one tail. So what is that? This one. So what is my probability? That is 1 by total 8. So my answer is 1 by 8. Very simple question. See the next question. A box contains 10 identical electronic components, of which 4 are defective. Okay, so we have 10 components in which 4 are defective. That means 6 are 4 defective, 6 good, right? So now, if 3 components are selected at random from the box in succession without replacing the units already drawn, what is the probability that 2 components of the selected components are defective? So that means 3 are drawn. We are drawing 3. That means from 10, how many ways we can draw? 10C3, right? 10 from 10, 3 we are drawing. Now what we need? We need 2 are defective. So out of this 3, 2 defective means 1 good. 2 defective, 1 good. So 1 good from this 6 good means 6C1, and 2 defective from this 4 means 4C2 divided by total 10C3. Okay, so this is what we need to find. Okay, so just solve this, you'll be getting the answer. So my answer is just solve this, you'll be getting 3 by 10. You'll be getting 3 by 10. So 4C3 means, what is NC3? NCRS, N factorial by R factorial into N minus R factorial. So once you solve this, 6C1s, that will be 6. Now 4C2 means 4 into 3 divide, 4 into 3 into 2 into 1 divided by 2 factorial into 2 factorial, that will again become 6, right? So divided by 10C3. Okay, then you'll be getting the answer as 3 by 10. Okay. Simultaneously drawn from the set 1 to 10. What is the conditional probability of getting exactly one of the two x and y being even, given x plus y is equal to 50? So what they are telling? We have numbers from 1 to etc. From that we have 1 to 10. We are drawing two numbers x and v, such that x plus y is equal to 15. Condition is given that x plus y is equal to 15. And what is the conditional probability of getting exactly one of the two numbers being even? One should be even. Exactly one should be even. Okay. So understand, we may think that this is a conditional probability question, but this is very easy if we go in our classical method. Understand? See, we need to get x plus y as 15. So what are the possibilities?
What are the possibilities? First one is 1 comma 14 is not there. 2 comma 13 is not there. So first one is 5 comma 10. Then second one 6 comma 9, 7 comma 8, then 8 comma 7, 9 comma 6, 10 comma 5. So these are the possible values,
right? To get 15, two numbers are drawn randomly. Now,
so how many possibilities, total outcomes? 6, right?
Total 6. Now, what is the situation they are telling? Exactly one number is even. So what is that possible? Exactly one number even here. One number is even. Here one number is even. Here one number is even. Here also. Here also. Here also. So what is our probability? Probability of exactly one even. That is 6 divided by total 6. Our answer is going to be 1. Okay. So just once they are telling conditional, you need not go for a conditional probability and all. Just see which is the method easy. So here classical method is easy, so just go for that. Okay, so let's see the next question. Let's see the next question. For a binomial distribution B of n comma p, B of n comma p, np is given as 4, np is given as 4, variance npq is equal to 4 by 3. What they are finding probability of x greater than or equal to 5. What is the probability of x greater than or equal to 5? How can we solve this? See, this much details are given. So np is equal to 4 implies here n 4q is equal to 4 by 3, that is q is equal to 1 by 3, isn't it? Q is equal to 1 by 3. Now what is p? P is equal to 1 minus q, that is 1 minus 1 by 3, that is equal to 2 by 3. So in binomial distribution, it's just as binomial theorem, it is same as binomial theorem. What they are telling now, p of x greater than or equal to 5, that means how we can write greater than or equal to 5 means first one will be 5. So n is so for that first we need n. What is n? So np is equal to 4. So n into p is 2 by 3 is equal to 4. Okay, so what you'll get? You'll get n as 6. So expand the binomial expansion for x greater than or equal to 5. So 6c5, x is 5, 6c5, p raised to 5, right? P raised to 5, q raised to 1, or 6c6, p raised to 6, q raised to 0. Okay, isn't it? Okay, so what you'll get? So what you'll get? Just solve. What is 6c5? That is nothing but 6. 6c6 is 1. Then p raised to 5 means 2 by 3 raised to 5. 2 by 3 raised to 5. Into q is 1 by 3 plus, here we'll have a 6 now. Here, what you'll get? You'll get 1 into p raised to 6. P raised to 6 means 1 by 3 raised to 6. So, what you'll be getting? You'll be getting 2 raised to 8. Sorry,
this is 65, that is 6 into p is 2 by 3, no? 2 by 3 raised to 5 into q is 1 by 3 plus 66 is 1. So that is p factorial, means p will be q raised to 0, that is also 1. P is 2 by 3. 2 by 3 raised to 6.
Okay,
now you solve this. 2 raised to 6 will come here by 3 raised to 5, isn't it? This will go, then plus this will become 64 by 3 raised to 6.
Okay, so once you solve this, what you will get? You will get 2 raised to 8 by 3 raised to 6. 2 raised to 8 by 3 raised to 6. That is option D. 2 raised to 8 by 3 raised to 6.
2 raised to 8 by 3 raised to 6.
So that is option D. Okay. Question, what is the question? An insurance company insured 2000 scooter drivers, 400 car drivers, 6000 truck drivers. So let's just take A, B, the event that's a scooter driver. A for scooter drivers. So how many scooter drivers are there? 2000. 2000 scooter drivers. Then B, that is car drivers, 4000 car drivers. Then C, that is 6000 truck drivers. 6000 truck drivers. So number of people representing scooter drivers we can take is A, B, then car, B, C, 6000. Okay, now they are telling probability that accident involving a scooter driver, a car driver and a truck driver. So accident probability for car driver, it's a 0.1. For first is they are given scooter driver, that is 0.1. 0.1 for scooter driver, 0.1. 0.01, then 0.03, 0.15. 0.01, 0.03, 0.03, then 0.15. Accident probabilities. Now, one of the insured person meets with accident, then the probability that the person is a scooter driver. Probability that the person is a scooter driver. That's what we need to check. Okay, let's see how to solve this. Let us take E be the event of accident to occur. Accident occurring. Okay, now what is this 0.301 hindrance? That means accident for a scooter driver, right? So how can we write this as P of accident for a scooter driver? Okay, so we can write it as P of E given A as 0.01, right? P of E given A, we can write it as 0.01. Next, P of E given B, we can write it as 0.03. P of E given C, we can write it as 0.15. One of the insured person meet with an accident, the probability that the person is a scooter driver. So it's given that accident has already occurred, and it should be, and they're asking what is the probability that it's a scooter driver. So what they're asking, accident has already occurred. Accident has already occurred means he has already occurred. Now what is the probability that it's a scooter driver? This is what we need to find. Okay, now see, what is the when you see these things, you need to understand that this is first of all Bayer's theorem. Okay, so three events and mentioning about another event. Okay, so we need to use Bayer's theorem here. Okay, so before that I'll write what is P of A. P of A is nothing but 2000 by this total is 2000 plus 4000 plus 6000, that is 12000. So first is 2000 by 12,000, 1 by 6, P of B, that is 2,000 by, that is 4,000 by 1,200, 1 by 3, P of C is 6,000 by 1,200,
that is 1 by 2. Okay, now we'll substitute these things in the theorem. Okay, so what is Bayes' theorem? What is Bayes' theorem? Bayes' theorem is P of A given E is equal to P of A into P of E given A divided by P of A into P of E given A plus P of B into P of E given B plus P of C into P of E given C. So now it's just that we substitute over here. So let's substitute here. See what we'll get when we substitute. 1 by 6 into P of E given A, that is 0.01, by 1 by 6 into same thing 0.01 plus 1 by 3 into 0.03 plus 1 by 2 into 0.15. So these are the things that we need to substitute over here. Okay, now just solve this, you'll be getting as just solve this, you will be getting the answer as, what are the options? 1 by 52, 3 by 52, 15 by 52, 19 by 52. You'll be getting the answer as 1 by 52. See the next question. What is the next question? A coin is tossed 5 times. The probability that tail appears an odd number of times is. Okay. Coin is tossed 5 times. So what is n? N is equal to 5 times. Okay. Now what do you need? Probability of tail appearing odd number of times. Probability of tail appearing odd number of times. Odd number of times. So this is what we need to find. Okay, now let's see how to do this. So here, understand, this is a binomial trial, right? So what we need to find, if suppose number of times that tail appears, that we are taking as x, we need to find p of x is equal to 1 or p of x is equal to 3 or p of x is equal to 5. Okay, now what is the probability that tail occurs? P of tail not occurring is also 1 by 2. So here we need to do it in binomial expansion. What is P of x equal to 1? That is 5 C 1 1 by 2 raised to 1. 1 by 2 raised to, this we can denote as P and this we can denote as Q. 1 by 2 raised to 4 plus 5 C 3. 1 by 2 raised to 3, 1 by 2 raised to 2, plus 5 C5, 1 by 2 raised to 5. So once we solve this, just expand, just do NCR, that is N factorial by R factorial into N minus R factorial. Then you will be getting the answer as 1 by 2. When you solve this, you will be getting the answer as 1 by 2. So what is the option? Option is option A, 1 by 2. Okay.